An appeal to Steve Outtrim. I wrote the following as a response to the YouTube videographer known as Monkey Savant in a comment thread on my YouTube channel Samizdat YouTube. Any dog is a far higher order of being than these conspiratorial nimrods. I much prefer the company of dogs and cats to that of humans. In any case, I am mystified by Outtrim. He is worth tens of millions of Aussie dollars and yet he is in the gutter with a convicted felon stalker who absconds from legal service. It just makes no sense. Steve Outtrim, Wikipedia, and his website, burners.me. The reference is to Thomas Schoenberger, whose criminal history is addressed in articles on my website Samizdat, see Cicada Files, Z3301, et al., for instance. Schoenberger is absconding from legal service, fleeing in effect, delaying justice by hiding. Outtrim is an egregious partisan endorsing Schoenberger's misconduct. No. I just had a conversation with an FBI supervisory special agent and she confirmed that reporting felonies in progress cannot under any circumstances be mischaracterized as gang stalking. In fact, I invite your law enforcement to contact me to address your claims of aggravated stalking and your threat to get me charged in absentia. I look forward to hearing from them. Outtrim contorts himself to defend the indefensible, he is beyond partisan, and he straight up lies, calling me a witch and a warlock, claiming that I admit to sorcery, casting personal medical information that I shared with other combat veterans in the most negative possible light. He is shameless. This refers to Outtrim's gotchas as he distorts statements made by me in various places and spins them to my detriment, again in comments, this time to an article by Jacqueline Weaver, Gabe Hoffman vs. Zachary McQuaid aka Zack Quaid, Tracking the Leopard Moroz, February 7, 2020, and it makes no sense. The stupid is epic in this screenshot from an article on Outtrim's blog. He will never live this down. Outtrim is angry at me because I did him the favor of advising him that he is flirting with a lawsuit. I did not tell him that he is sued, because he is not yet sued. But I did say that he is liable to get sued, as he is implicated with his current confederates and involved in their inimical enterprises. First off, the link in the word Bangkok is to an article about an infamous expat neighborhood where someone opened a museum that claims that CIA officers hung out there. See what he did there? Next, I never self-described as a researcher. That is Outtrim's word, he tags me with it, then he puts it in quotes, to mock me. His expression statement of claim by a plaintiff to initiate a lawsuit is how he refers to me advising him to watch his language with Gabe Hoffman, because Hoffman is litigious, capable and entirely willing to sue the shit out of scumbags like Outtrim who defame him, particularly in anti-Semitic terms. I do Outtrim a favor, but he considers it lies. And this is the truth. I did Outtrim a favor. I am not threatening him. I am advising him, and my advice is free, with no strings attached. Outtrim puts himself in a vulnerable position, and he gets mad at me for telling him so. He should consider that his legal position is shaky. If he steps just a little bit further and makes the wrong statements about the wrong person again, he is likely to find himself sued. I invite any law enforcement official investigating the death of Stone County Sheriff Sergeant Michael Stephen on July 19, 2019 to contact me. I have information for you. I have already referred this information to FBI. Outtrim can defame me all that he likes. I do not need to be liked or admired by him. I do not think that he can hurt my feelings, as I really do not care what he thinks about me. My reputation stands on its own merits, and I am pretty much impermeable to anything that anyone like him can do or say. I barely replied to Outtrim's smear on me on his blog, published as A858 vs. The Cat Ladies, Part 2 Spooky Steven and the Game, where Spooky Steven refers to me and he accuses me of sending him malware, consorting with notorious Satanist Michael Aquino, and writes he claims to be a warlock slash magician. These are not just lies, they are defamation, particularly when you understand that the terms warlock and magician in Outtrim's lexicon are satanic, specifically in a context citing Michael Aquino. The malware was embedded by whomever sent him the email, my connection to it was no connection at all. Outtrim also claims that I commit the sin of linking to a person that I still never exchanged a word with, Glenn Herman of Magico, on Keybase. Finally, Outtrim accuses me of being an informant for Gabe Hoffman. I sympathize with Mr. Hoffman, but I do not know him well enough for any court to consider him my associate, or even a friend. As for informant, I have zero tolerance for anti-Semitism. Finally, Outtrim illustrates his crushing personal ignorance by mischaracterizing Dr. John Dee's Monas Hieroglyphica as satanic, and he gets mad because I notice his anti-Semitism. Apparently Steve Outtrim considers tweets like this amusing. I do not get the joke. I am dear friends with an eminent artist whose father died in the Nazi prison camps, and I was privileged to serve with Israeli special operators. I have to wonder, in fact, whether this is an intentional dangle by Outtrim, as it strikes me as so egregious. But then maybe he is just this stupid, and this anti-Semitic. I am not suing anybody, unless Outtrim gets so egregious that an enterprising Kiwi lawyer perceives that a defamation suit is a slam dunk and offers to take the case on contingency. I would collaborate with such a lawsuit and surrender all proceeds to charitably benefit New Zealand veterans of war. So if anyone knows a Kiwi lawyer who wants to make some easy money, send him my way. Outtrim already defamed me. It is easily proven. Alongside? You may come to regret that carefully chosen word, Mr. Outtrim. Maybe you were not quite careful enough. All that I ever did to Outtrim was give him advice and tell everyone to Google his name to read articles in the Aussie press about his gross body odor and bad breath. I did not write those articles. I am sure that they are incorrect. Nobody can be that disgusting. But he made yet another bad decision, getting involved with a pathetic woman who whispered malign rumors about him to Aussie journalists. So, yes, I made some videos that mock Outtrim. I called him names. Especially after he tried to manipulate Ms. Denise Matto, who never did anything to him. Another example of Outtrim getting mobbed up with scumbags, consorting with idiots. I do not think that Outtrim has defamed me to a terrible degree yet. And I do not consider being called a witch an insult, in any case. I was born a Catholic and raised that way. Over years I learned my own blend of pantheism, and I found my own personal beliefs mirrored in Giordano Bruno and Shaivism. I only wrote an entire book about this. Revelation is free for download on Academia, ResearchGate, Google Books, and elsewhere. Look to the left beneath my welcome to this site. See all those links? Free book. You can buy it, as well, if you want to buy me a cup of coffee for writing it. I am trying to wake Steve Outtrim up. I am trying to help him. I should probably send him the rebuttal that I wrote about his article about me. He did commit to publish such rebuttals on his own site. After all, I cannot be held responsible for anyone googling Steve Outtrim body odor. Be advised laughter may ensue. Posted by Esteban Trujillo de Gutierrez at Monday, February 24, 2020.